Hi, I'm Adriana Baranek, and you're watching the UseWise channel, the Miadria Group channel dedicated to UseWise, the platform that we are building to create one place where companies will be able to buy, deploy, and automate services from various public cloud vendors. Today, we will be talking about the choice between moving to the cloud versus staying on-premise. If you are someone that is in charge of making decisions related to the future of information technology in your company, you are for sure faced with many important decisions every day. And while we are really a company that was born in the cloud and that is building UseWise platform that will facilitate your move to the public cloud, we are perfectly aware of how difficult your job is. If you have any kind of history, you have many systems that have to be reliable and running for 24 hours for sure. And in that regard, we are always very careful when we propose new solutions for you. However, the time has passed when only early adopters were the ones moving their essential workloads to the cloud. And today I will explain it a little bit further on some typical examples. Let's suppose that you have some problems that you would like solved. For instance, you are introducing SAP as your new ERP system. It is a huge project and plenty of your resources will undoubtedly be involved in the preparation of work process part of the deployment, working with consultants. And when it comes to the harder part of the project, you might be inclined to go back to the default way of thinking and just use an on-premise installation. However, this example is a very basic example when you really should be thinking about the cloud. Staying on-premise and just doing it the way it has always been done will be a huge mistake. If you build SAP on-premise, you will always have to either maintain the high availability even at times when none will be accessing it, or you will struggle to keep up with the high demand at the peak usage planning end of month reporting and such periods. In both of those scenarios, on-premise will not be flexible and will come at a huge cost. You also forget that you need to have everything doubled so that you have a proper disaster recovery setup. You need to have it backed up, and if anything goes wrong, you really need to be well prepared. So basically it means double licenses, double hardware, so it is a very complex issue. Using the cloud for your new SAP deployment makes so much more sense. It offers you flexibility with the same features. And I'm talking about running it on Azure, AWS, or GCP, which are all certified by SAP. This is a very important point. So SAP has worked with those big public cloud providers, and they're all certified by SAP that those instances are fully compatible with SAP. And plus, there is a big plus that you will not have any worries regarding the operating system, which can in many cases be Linux, and it will need to be maintained, and it will come as part of your service if you use it on the big public cloud. If you use it on premise, you will need to find the Linux expert, and they will need to, you know, they might charge you a lot if they are out external consultants, so it is a very complex issue. It is also very important that you do not fall into trap of talking just to one side about this SAP, and that you talk about it with someone that has zero experience with SAP in the cloud. It could be very dangerous because there are lots of SAP consultants even out there that would prefer staying on premise and that would give you an advice that you might really have a problem with a few years down the road. We have done successful deployments and we work with all the platforms, and we will be more than happy to take a look at your specific projects if you need help. Another typical example would be when you're looking to replace the old version of your Exchange server. Email server in the cloud with G Suite or Office 365 is really a no-brainer in that case. Deploying new on-premise Exchange server in 2019 is a futile endeavor, and it will bring you more headache than anything. And one thing that you should bear in mind is that talking to old world consultants that have vested interest in helping you remain on premise and not using the new technology, even though they might be pretending to care about the cloud, will bring you some of the typical suggestions that will in reality not change a thing. Examples are hybrid cloud, putting your service in rented space, hosted solutions, and stuff like that. Have your hopes up for the new kind of services, for services that can truly transform the way that you work and that your employees use IT, and look beyond just one vendor, and you will discover an entire new world, and you will discover many new benefits that you can gain with having an open mind. And just because things have been done in a certain way for decades, and you have certainly currently set up one amazing on-premise setup that is serving its purpose, it doesn't mean that there are no better solutions out there and that you shouldn't be looking for out for them. The important thing to note is that it does not have to be done with a big bang also. You can start your move to the cloud slowly with few workloads that are important but not critical and see how it goes. Then you make a precise timeline on how to migrate other workloads and you start using some new services. You might be in the end surprised to realize how quickly this all will happen once you get a grip of it. New things are definitely scary, and this is why we are building UseWise. We want to give you the same level of assurance that you are in charge and in control, help you avoid vendor lock-in, which unfortunately is not something that many companies are doing when they're on-premise, example of so-called Microsoft shops. And we can help you make your road to the cloud easy and seamless so that you can focus on your business and supporting your business leaders in their business decisions and not worrying about things that are not essential to these efforts. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the like button on the video, subscribe and hit the little bell. We will be posting new videos every Monday. I'm looking forward to having you as my future audience. Have a great day. We will be keeping ourselves busy in the meantime, and I will see you very soon. Thank you so much. Bye.